Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Before going to the video, those who are not subscribed our channel, subscribe it and also click the bell button. In this video, we are going to see about tunnel diode. Tunnel diode was invented in 1958 by Leo Isaacki. Hence, it is also known as Isaacki diode. It is a type of semiconductor with a special characteristic of negative resistance. That is, as we increase the voltage, the current decreases. As we decrease the voltage, the current increases. It is a heavily doped PN junction that is about 10 nanometer wide. The doping density of tunnel diode is 1000 times higher than that of ordinary diode. The materials used for fabricating tunnel diode are germanium, gallium arsenide and gallium antimonide. Of this, germanium is most widely used. The ratio of peak value of the forward current to the value of valley current is maximum in case of germanium and it is less in case of silicon. Hence, silicon is not used for the fabrication of tunnel diode. Next is the heavy doping effects of tunnel diode. The heavy doping in tunnel diode reduces the width of depletion layer to extremely a small value, about 0.00001 millimeter. It also reduces the forbidden energy gap to a small value, that is, energy gap between the conduction band and valence band. It reduces the reverse breakdown voltage to a small value. It also causes negative resistance in the characteristics. That is, as we increase the voltage, the current decreases, and as we decrease the voltage, the current increases. It also allows the tunnel diode to conduct for all the reverse voltages. Next is the operation of tunnel diode. It works on the principle of tunneling. For thin barrier, quantum mechanics says that the electron wave nature will allow it to tunnel through the barrier. When the P and N region are heavily doped, the depletion region becomes very thin, approximately 10 nanometer. In such case, there is a finite probability that electrons can tunnel from the conduction band of N region to the valence band of P region. During this tunneling, the energy of the particle does not change. When the semiconductor is very heavily doped, the Fermi level goes above the conduction band for N type and below the valence band for P type material. These materials are called degenerate materials. If you consider tunnel diode, at zero bias, there is no flow of current. When a small forward bias is applied, the potential barrier is still very high, so no forward current through the junction. However, the electrons in the conduction band of N region will tunnel according to the quantum mechanics to the holes of the valence band in P region. This will create a forward bias tunnel current. With the applied voltage larger, the energy of the majority of electrons in the N region is equal to that of the holes in the valence band of P region, and this will produce maximum tunneling current. As the forward bias voltage is increased, the number of electrons in the N side that are directly opposite to the holes in the valence band decrease. Therefore, the tunneling current starts decreasing. As more forward voltage is applied, the tunneling current drops to zero. But the regular diode forward current due to electron hole injection increases since the potential barrier is lower. With further increase in voltage, the tunnel diode IV characteristics is similar to that of regular PN junction diode. Now, under reverse bias condition, the electrons in the valence band of p side tunnel directly towards the holes present in the conduction band of n side, creating larger tunneling current which increases with the application of reverse voltage. The reverse IV characteristics of tunnel diode is similar to that of Zener diode with nearly zero breakdown voltage. The IV characteristic of tunnel diode has two distinct features. First is, it is strongly non-linear compared to the IV characteristics of resistor. That is, the current voltage relationship for tunnel diode cannot be described using the Ohm's law. The second one is, it has negative differential resistance region. That is, in this region, as we increase the voltage, the current decreases. The total current in the tunnel diode is given by tunnel current plus diode current plus excess current. The tunnel current is given by I10 is equal to V by R0 into E to the power minus V by V0 to the power M. M ranges from 1 to 3, V0 ranges from 0.1 to 0.5 volt. R0 is the tunnel diode resistance in the ohmic region. Maximum negative differential resistance can be found by using the formula RD max is equal to R0 into E to the power 1 plus M by M divided by M. The peak voltage is given by Vp is equal to 1 by M to the power 1 by M into V0. The diode current is given by I diode is equal to Is into E to the power V by eta Vth minus 1. Here, Is is the saturation current, eta is the ideality factor, and it is 1 for germanium and 2 for silicon. Vth is the voltage, which is equal to kT by Q. Excess current is given by I excess is equal to V by Rv into E to the power V minus Vv by Vex. Here, Vv is the valley voltage and Rv is the valley resistance, where Ixs is an additional tunneling current related to parasitic tunneling via impurities. Rv and Vx are the empirical parameters. In high quality diodes, Rv value will be much greater than R0. Vx can have value from 1 to 5 volt. Next is the applications of tunnel diode. It is used as microwave oscillator at a frequency of about 10 GHz. It is used as an ultra high speed switch because of tunneling. It acts as a logic memory storage device. Because of its negative resistance, it is used as relaxation oscillator circuit. It is used in FM receivers. Thanks for watching the video. For more videos, subscribe to our channel.